Don't say it's love. You know it ain't sweet enough. Just don't say it's love. I've heard this shit too much. Just
so let me catch y'all up. Alright. Welcome back to a weekly vlog. One of the days are gonna be my last day at work. And I know what you're thinking.
Oh, you just started this job.
I did just start this job and I didn't wanna quit. When opportunity comes, take it, because you don't know when the next opportunity is going to come. So I do feel bad that I have to leave, even though I've only been here a month and that was not the plan. Like, it wasn't the plan, but I will say, when I started at the new company, so what we're gonna do is, this is the storyline, right? We're gonna do company, we're gonna name them company one, company two, company three, right? So I had a manager in company one that went to be a regional at a new company. So when she left, my office just didn't feel the same. So I was like, okay, so she went on to new endeavors. It's time for me to get up out of here too. Plus, you know, we are close and she was just like, I don't see you being here no more than like a year. I'm like, you're right. And then you need to move up. So company one just didn't have any opportunities for me at the time. They didn't have no like assistant managers. They didn't have any, no, just anything that I saw for myself. You know, I could have went to the corporate building, but I didn't want to be in corporate at the moment. That's why I really like being in this industry, because you get to be at a desk, but you also get to move around a lot and you get, you know, customer interaction and you're kind of like your own boss in a way. I left company one to go to company two. Got a little pay raise because I've already had experience in the industry, da 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 da. Right? So, boom. After that, my manager from company one, that is now a regional for her company, she reached out and she was just like, you know, I have a position for you and it starts at this amount. And I'm like, this could change the trajectory of my finances and my situation. Like, my situation isn't bad, but I knew it was gonna take me time to get to where I want. Like, rent and mortgage is the last thing on my mind. Right now, the goal is to make a certain salary. Even with social media tied into, that's just my goal at the moment. Like, stay home as long as you can until you get your dream salary. And she was like, look, I got this position for you, yada, 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 and it's remote. And I'm like, at the time, I'm like, I don't wanna be remote. Like, I enjoy going to work. I enjoy fixing my coffees. I enjoy getting cute for the office. Like, I enjoy my interactions. I don't wanna be remote at the moment, right? But it's so crazy because when I went on my vacation, me and my partner were speaking and we were saying how, you know, like, we're very inspired by travel creators and things of that nature. Like, we think, you know, traveling for a career would be so cool. Like, how would we even make that happen if we were to actually do it? So that was a topic of conversation. So that was like one bullet point in there, right? So two, the second bullet point is that how she just called me and she was like, I got this remote position for you. And we were also talking about how, like, the only way we could see that happening for ourselves is if we work remote. And then she offers me a remote position. So I'm just like, what the heck, right? So, and plus I've been thinking about this all the time too. Like, I'm always researching, like, the same industry, so we're still leasing, property management, etc., like real estate, all of that, but we're just looking at like different, like, positions, I would say, that involve all of that because you have like experience, right? So I'm at company two, and company two uses a certain software that this new company uses. And so I was only here for a month, but this new company, company three, uses the same software that company two uses. And company three, what she offered me was, of course, I'm gonna be doing triple the work, but it's remote and I'll have like multiple properties, right? So a part of me feels as if like it was meant to happen. Like, I feel bad, like I was only here for a month, but it was meant to happen. I went to company two, learned these new systems, learned this new software at an entry level position. And then now I was just offered something like big girl position and it's using that same software. So now I don't have to go in my first week feeling defeated, because my first week here, I felt, at company two, I felt very defeated. I feel like it's just so much, like, just four or five girls like on the floor, and it's like people are just hungry for leases, etc. And it was just not my vibe, because I came from an office that it was just me, myself, and I. And a month in, like, now I feel like, dang, like, I actually like these people now. And now I have to leave. I had to tell them I had to go. But after a year or two, you kind of succeed. Like, if you've mastered it, it's time for you to go to another level. So even in company two, I was looking for other positions, but they were telling me that I couldn't do it unless I was in this position for like 3 months. Well, they called me when I was on a boat in St. Martin, and it was like, oh my god, they loved you, we're gonna offer you this X, Y, and Z. And I'm just like, what else would Beyonce do? Beyonce would say yes. So I said yes, and now I start my remote position on the 18th, And yeah, I recently just got my desk and everything from Amazon, so I'm gonna show you guys my work from home setup because I do have a small little area in my house. So I'm gonna show you guys my small little work from home setup. And yeah, I'm also looking at townhomes too, might as well, because work without prayer, prayer without work is dead. You can say you want this, that, and third, but if you don't put no action into it. And I also feel as if like that's another reason why I was blessed with this opportunity, because God sees how much work I put into getting the things that I want. I'm just super excited. So that's funny. These townhomes are like, they're new construction, like new construction, like just was knocked down. Like, you know, I don't plan on buying something until like probably next year winter. So wow, I just wanted to go see what it looks like. Maybe they probably three houses is built. Where the rest of the houses? All right guys, we're gonna go to Target because I haven't been to Target in a long time. Y'all ever wonder how the girls have their skin to be so glowy? It's either baby oil or shea butter. Julia put me on years ago, okay? And of course, I just needed me an eco style gel, nothing too crazy. But I was just like, I just don't think they have shea butter. And the next thing you know, I ran into it. If you guys look up Laurelwood, Ashenwood, they have new construction builds all over the US. And I'm just thinking to myself, like, if I'm paying $1,600 for a mortgage, just make it make sense. Why pay $1,600 for rent when I can pay $1,600 for a mortgage? You see what I'm saying? And look, these have the same style as an apartment as well. It's so crazy. But yes, what would I need a 3-3 for? I'm not sure, but this is beautiful. You can always use it. A guest bedroom, a desk area. Closet space isn't that big, but it's bigger than what I have right now. Bigger than what I have right now. And it's a new construction community, so half of the properties aren't even fully built yet. Yeah, I'm not sure why I have this glare going on, y'all. This is really, really nice. I love it. Love it, love it, love it, love it.
So if you can get in early in phase one, which is what you're in,
okay,
you get a better price. Because as we continue to build, prices will increase.
Yeah. Oh, I heard that.
This is the building.
Okay.
Lot 125 starts in the corner, goes up to 129. The only one that has sold so far is lot 126. So of a gray color tone, and I'll show you what that's going to look like. But 307, 310.
Okay. But my thing is, how can you trust that
Like, it's gonna look exactly what it's gonna look like.
So the cool thing, even like the interior, you still get a lot of natural light. So it doesn't feel like you're not in or you're enclosed. Same exact layout we just left.
I don't know what this little glare was, y'all. I'm sorry about that. But y'all, I want my house here. 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 I want to say it 3,000 times. I want my house here. And he was so sweet. He was even telling me about, you know, real estate and stuff like that. Because y'all know.
Y'all know.
I did my first test, failed it. But I have a chance to do the second test. But I'm a little nervous to do the second test. If y'all can just send me some encouragement, like, I'll try to do it again. And we'll see. But the thing is, if you take the test twice and you fail it again, then you gotta take the whole class all over again. That's my thing. So I just don't want to waste my time. I want my house to be here. I want my house to be here. Period, point blank. Oh, you can look at other places. No, this is on my whole hearts of hearts. This is it. They have other places in like Duluth and Alpharetta, but I don't know. I feel like this is where I want it to be. And it's not that far away from the airport too. If I gotta go places, like, This is it. All right. I just had the best, catch my breath. I just had the best Chipotle chicken and bacon pizza from Panera Bread. Amazing, phenomenal. So some of my work from home stuff have already came. Stuff I'm just like, girl, why did you even buy this? So this is like a cute little pen holder, put all of my pens and things. Might not my neck, but my Apple Watch, but it's just a little bit different. Like, it's gonna go seamlessly with my desk. Like, I just love everything brown and tan. So we just gotta do what we can with what we have. Y'all, all I saw was this and I had freaked out because I'm like, what did I order? Okay. Yeah, it's a lot going on here. I don't know. I think it needs to be closer to the wall. I'm not liking it. So it's not bad. I'll probably, so it goes all the way up. I'm at the door. I was gonna bring you guys to work with me, but then it just got so busy because everybody called out today. I don't know, I done put my 2 weeks in and everybody calling out. Today was so hectic, but I like working by myself because everything can just flow very seamless and very, like, you know, just calmly. Because when you got coworkers, they got like attitudes and it's just rude, then it's like the office just become hostile. Become hostile for no reason. Easier. And yes, not everybody's the best, but you know, that ain't got nothing to do with me. So weird. Like, my face looks a little bit clearer. When I came back from St. Martin, I got a little bit of a tan. And I have a long ponytail, but I have it like wrapped in a little bun. But so I get a lot of questions about, you know, how do you start leasing, etc. Well, first of all, a leasing is an entry-level position. This is never nothing I wanted to do. However, this is kind of like the plan God kind of has me on. So who am I to question it and fight the fight? So I kind of just transitioned into it. And I know some people that are like, ugh, they're tired of their careers and they want to transition into something else. Who's to say I might be a chef next year? I don't freaking know. So if anything, I'm just going with the flow, and I became really good at it after like a year and some change. So when people ask me like, how do you do leasing, etc., especially the people that I did like RA work with at Disney, we did like resident experience, etc., they're like, oh my god, how do you do it? So what I tell people all the time is you need to go to Indeed and you make sure you have a LinkedIn, especially for like social media stuff. If you're trying to look for people that do like PR work or social media, 9 times out of 10, go to LinkedIn, put in the company's name, Pretty Little Things for an example, and put in like PR or like social media content. Cause people are gonna be excited to say like, oh, I do PR for X, Y, and Z brand, right? But anyway, so you go to LinkedIn, you go to Indeed, and you basically duplicate success. I'll always say that. It's not copycat. It's if you see this is how this person got successful, I'm gonna mimic that but make it my own. I say it all the time. So what I do is for my resume, and this is what I did as well to get my new position working from home, doing property management work, but still at a mid-senior level position, right? So I go to Indeed, I go to LinkedIn, and there's always a description of a role that needs to be done. So what I would do is I would take all of those descriptions and I would just put those descriptions in the job work that I'm doing now. You said you need somebody that's really good with Microsoft Word, etc. That's exactly what you're gonna see on my resume, baby. Exactly. And when people, y'all, when I say I've been here and today they had 2 interviews and I had to look at their resumes before they went in, I was like, these are not really good resumes, like at all. I don't want to be a party pooper, but these resumes were really bad. And people say all the time, like, oh, do we need college? You don't need college.
Baby, you need college, okay? I don't care.
Nobody says like the experience and the things you can and cannot do. Like, it's just reading, writing, and arithmetic, but goodness gracious, these were terrible. These were terrible resumes that I saw. And so, if anything, what I always do is I always have a manager and a professor and my mom and dad look at my resumes. Like, I know some people don't have that, but if you want to be in, you know, transition into like corporate and like something more professional, because I know there's a lot of people that do like bar work, there's a lot of bottle girls that want to transition into being professional, there's a lot of people that working in restaurant industry that want to transition into something professional. Now, was this my plan? Like I said, no, because I wanted to be a teacher, I wanted to be in the classroom, I wanted to have colors all on the wall, but then something in me just changed and now I'm this like minimalistic blue brown, not blue, but black brown beige like type of person. I don't know, I'm trying to add color back, but anyway. But yeah, that's basically how I would say transition into the industry. You have experience in sales, you're just nice, you're kind to people. That's basically all they're looking for, because you would be the first face people would see when you walk on their property. Okay, so this is the setup for my cold brew drink this morning. And I think I'm gonna just show you guys the actual video. I'm gonna snip it here and then tell you guys what ingredients I use. Alright, so she's made. So I kind of just made the OG brew. Typically, you can get the brews at Starbucks, and all they are is water and concentrated coffee with a sweetener. Boom. So that's basically what I did. I had water, I had a concentrate, and then I had sugar because I don't have a sweetener with me right now. And then I took the pumpkin spice Starbucks cream, and I mixed it with brown sugar and pumpkin spice, and then I put pumpkin spice a little bit on the top. So yeah, I'm probably gonna put this on my Instagram, so go over there and watch the full thing. For a second, I thought I forgot to almost record it. Y'all, so today I'm starting ballet. You're probably wondering, what the heck? Like, why are you starting ballet? Girl, why you not starting ballet? I've always heard this saying that was like, you know, you need at least three hobbies, and one of those hobbies have to be for, you know, good physical use. And so I haven't been going to these yoga, free yoga classes in Atlanta because I just feel like they're just so full. It just be like 50 people in a class. You can barely hear the instructor. Adult gymnastics, I would have broke my skating. There's no, if I was to practice skating more, it would be at a tennis court. One day I came across this beautiful creator that was like, she's starting ballet as an adult, and I was like, why not? And there's a free class going on right now. It's such a beautiful studio. Look at her. Yes, honey, you better take pictures of you doing ballet. I'm driving to work today and then tomorrow. So if anything, I am feeling really good. I have a question for y'all though. What do y'all believe is the best, either hourly or salary? Y'all leave the comments in below, because I feel like there's benefits to both of them. And they called me yesterday and they made like a little joke. They're like, hee hee hee, at least your salary. What is that even like? What did I just sign and sell my organs to y'all? Like, I'm so confused. I need to like my team, and that kind of sucks. But I just want to show y'all my hair this morning because I did it yesterday. You know, sometimes it's not all about, you know, doing the little baby hairs and everything. You just slap it on. Desk. We took the other desk back, y'all. It was a no for me. All right, so these are all the pieces for the chair. I'm gonna build it off camera, and then y'all will be able to see after. Yeah, all this stuff, y'all. Call me Bog the Builder. So it could have been a little bit bigger, because this little area, but I'm not mad at it. I'm gonna scoot this over just a little bit more, and then boom. It looks amazing. For someone that has a very small space, I do what I can, okay? Because at first I was like, oh my God, I don't want a work from home, because I wouldn't know what to do. Like, I still am with my mom. So it's just like, you know, I don't have, my room is my sanctuary. So if anything, I think this is so cute. And yeah. Now this might get on my nerves eventually, because it's not the best quality, but this desk is all I needed. The first one, we took it back today. So the wireless charge phone, I would actually show y'all how it works, but I'm using the phone. And then of course, a cute little pin cup that matches the aesthetic of my actual like items in here. It's just sunglasses and just miscellaneous things. And then of course, like a cute little big plant in here. Love it. All of it, of course, is in my Amazon storefront. All right, you guys, back in the car. I like this wig. Doesn't look too bad. So it's my last day. I feel so bad, because I actually like the company. I like the people. So that's why I wanted to do it correctly. I wanted to get like 2 weeks and everything. But I feel so bad, because like, I just feel bad. But I'm so nervous to start my new position, y'all. Like, I'm so scared. Because, like, double the money, it's gonna be double the problems, double the stress, all of that, right? So, yeah. But I want you guys to comment down below whether you guys think I should get a different vlogging camera. Like, I vlog on the GoPro, but I also feel like quality doesn't necessarily mean success. And me personally, like, the GoPro is cute and all, but I just saw someone promote this cute vlogging camera that was like 10 features in one. You get the microphone, you get the face-to-face action, you get the miniature size, and the quality looks amazing. I don't know, so y'all tell me. Like, yes, I've already invested into this GoPro and everything, but me personally, I don't have a problem with selling it or giving it to my cousins that also want to do content creation. So it's just like, I don't know, y'all let me know. I just feel like probably when I get to maybe 10k or 5k, I don't know, if God willingly blesses me with that, like, you know. But yeah, y'all leave y'all comments below if y'all feel as if like quality is not a big thing, because sometimes I think with non-quality it gives like vintage and all that type of stuff. So I don't know, you guys let me know. Sure. I have to pee so bad, you guys. I don't know where this left off at, but I had my last day and it was filled with love. I do say that myself. It was filled with love, and then my girl was like, you know, let's go get drinks and celebrate your last day. I'm like, I wasn't even here that freaking long for us to even make this bond. But it's just like, it just doesn't even matter. Like, it doesn't even matter. Y'all, I have to go to the bathroom so freaking bad. I had a good last day. Oh, you don't know who knows who, and you always leave on a clean slate, and that's just really that. So yeah.